US witnessing a banking crisis. For the third time in just 6 weeks, another American bank has collapsed.
美国又有银行撑不住了。这一次的主角是总部设在旧金山的第一共和银行。
Sources tell CNN that federal regulators held an auction for the ailing bank on Sunday.
第一共和银行遭金融当局接管，最后确定由小摩摩根大通收购。
This is the third major bank failure. That is worrisome, of course. When you look at the top four banking failures, the first one was Washington Mutual. That was in 2008. The next three have all happened in the last two months.
摊开美国史上前四大银行倒闭案，2008年华盛顿。互惠银行申请破产，到今年三月有两家，分别是矽谷银行跟纽约签名银行，四月则是第一共和银行。不过这次市场似乎没有那么恐慌。
导致美国第一共和银行暴雷的根本原因是其过度扩张的资金结构。当时该行的贷款和长期投资与存款的比例已经高达111%。
专家分析，第一共和银行早就存在系统性问题。由于它是一间主要锁定富人客群、提供优惠低利贷款的银行，主要据点在加州、纽约、波士顿跟佛州，但它旗下的存款竟然有68%是没有美国 FDIC 担保的，意味存户很可能听到一点风声就出现挤兑风险。
That's the digital age. World has changed. You get some tweets and people saying, hey, we may have a problem with this bank. People will move their money first. They'll ask questions later.
第一共和银行上周公布财报，民众大幅提款导致存款失血问题比预期严重，股价有如自由落体，直线下坠。从今年三月$122到五月下市前只剩下每股$3.51，跌幅将近97%。这一波美国中小型银行倒闭潮也跟联准会这个礼拜是否再次升息有关。
We wouldn't expect any big effects from one more quarter percentage point increase in short.Term interest rates. It will put just a little bit more pressure on the economy, just a little bit more pressure on inflation.
到底会不会再升息一码？有市场分析认为，想解决流动性问题，联准会也可能被迫提前降息。
And I think they're almost done. I hope they're almost done because I do think that the upcoming slowdown in lending by the regional banks is going to do some of the Fed's dirty work.
升不升息，市场有分歧，但美国政府现在还有一个更头痛的难题。
For over 200 years, America has never, ever, ever failed to pay its debt. To put in the capital in colloquial terms, America is not a deadbeat nation.
美国财政部又敲响警钟，说政府目前现金不足，如果再不提高债务上限，六月份将无法偿还外债。
The president said he's happy to meet with McCarthy, but not on whether or not the debt limit gets extended. That's not negotiable. We are continue to be very firm about that, to be very clear. The president again said this himself.
拜登紧急召集国会领袖讨论，但目前两党在债务上限问题没有达成任何协议。如果美国出现债务违约，很可能会削弱美元作为世界货币领头羊的地位。
It makes it more expensive to borrow in dollars and it decreases the money supply. And that means that many countries around the world, especially those in the global south, that have to get access to dollars to pay for imports of commodities.
像南美阿根廷，政府开始实施新政策，停止使用美元，而是改用人民币结算从大陆进口的商品。另外，巴西也发出抗议。
Que todos os países estão obrigados a fazer seu comércio lastreado no dólar.
美元长期依靠的是美国的信用，但随着债务违约出现隐忧，加上俄乌战争对俄罗斯的制裁，恐怕去美元化的趋势正在发酵。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
TVBS 新闻直播回到 YouTube 频道了，提醒您每周一到周五的晚间7点到9点，由新化主播为各位新闻化重点，记得一定要来参加直播。